Hello everyone, I'm Steve Busalacchi, Superbolt Global Product Manager.
And I'm Bob McCurdy, Superbolt Product Manager for North America. In this video today, Steve and I are going to demonstrate the proper installation and removal procedure of Superbolt multi-jackbolt tensioners, or as commonly known as MJTs.
Okay, now we're going to show you the simple steps for installation of a Superbolt tensioner. From the factory, with each shipment, you have the Superbolt. It's pre-lubricated. You get an instruction sheet, and you also receive a general tensioner installation sheet, which is specific to this tensioner. So let's go. So we will run this down by hand, and then we back it off about 1/8 of a turn. The first step is we're going to hit 4 jack bolts, which we have marked. We will do those to the 50% torque level.
We're going to start at 12 o'clock, go to 6 o'clock, 3 o'clock, 9 o'clock pattern. The targeted torque for this particular tensioner is 80 foot-pounds. For step one, we're going to go to 50% of the targeted torque, which in this case is 40 foot-pounds. We'll apply that to each jack bolt. A key thing here is a lot of people feel the need that you have to stabilize at this point. Once your wrench clicks off, you just move on.
There's a click.
Now, that completes step one. Once your wrench clicks off, you move on to step two.
We go to the same 4 jack bolts, but now we're at the 100% level.
Correct, which is the 80 foot-pounds, our targeted torque.
Same 4 jack bolts.
Staying in the same pattern, 12, 6, 3, and 9. Again, once your wrench clicks off, we move on. We do not need to stabilize. That is step two, we're done. All right, so we've made our two passes, one at 50%, one at 100% of our cross pattern. Now we will begin in a circular pattern. We'll start again right back at the 12 o'clock mark. As you can see, that jack bolt is a little bit loose. That's common. Once you go around to the starting point, it will actually be loose. All the other jack bolts are now starting to be loaded.
Because we're adding tension into the stud as we're
Correct.
Tightening, right? Okay, so that's one pass around.
Now we'll begin our second circular pattern. Obviously you can see the jack bolts are not stabilized yet. Stabilized jack bolts, we want to see the wrench turned less than 20 degrees. Okay, so rotation. If you have your wrench straight up, I want to see less than that 20 degree rotation. I'm going to start beginning the second round.
I think it's safe to say shorter studs don't have as much stretch, so we will tighten, you know, quicker. Longer studs require more stretch, maybe
a
few more passes.
Yep, very, very good point. Back to 12 o'clock. That's well within your 20 degree rotation. At this point, we consider the jack bolts to be stabilized and up to full load.
So that's it, that's simple.
It's that simple.
Okay, we're gonna do the removal now, and it's just as easy as the installation. Just a couple things to remember for doing the removal is we only work in a circular pattern, and we wanna gradually unload the bolted connection. So this means we only do 1/8 of a turn on the jack bolts working in a circular pattern. This would be for the first pass. All right, Bob, now that we did that first pass at 1/8 of a turn, we can take another pass. This time we can open up the
full quarter
movement
turn.
To a quarter turn.
Full quarter turn, yep.
All right. So I think now we continue making additional passes at a quarter turn. We're gradually unloading the bolt.
And you can see how much easier the wrench is starting to turn now. But still maintain the quarter turn.
think we have it, Bob.
There you go.
Fully loosened, following the procedures, very simple steps, very easy to do. And that's how you install and remove Superbolt multi-jackbolt tensioners. Follow the proper procedures, and you can enjoy many years of safe, secure connections on a wide range of applications.
Absolutely, Steve. We have a lot of customers who can testify to the quality and durability of Superbolt products,
which we love to hear.
Yep.
Thank you all for watching, and please reach out to us at Nordlock Group for more information or for help with any other bolting challenges you may have.